Okay, so now we go to section 109, exempt transactions. You familiarize yourselves with this class, but better if you can memorize. Good luck memorizing this provision, this one. But you have to read this and understand or remember. The idea here is, okay, you must know the distinction between a zero-rated transaction and an exempt transaction. In the case of CIR versus Seagate technology, the Supreme Court distinguished automatic zero-rated transaction or the effective zero-rated transaction from exempt transactions. Okay, in terms of the VAT computation, zero rating and exemption are the same, of course, zero. But the extent of relief that results from either one of them is not. Applying the destination principle, do you remember this? This one, destination principle, cross-border doctrine, okay? To the exportation of goods, automatic zero rating is primarily intended to be enjoyed by the seller who is directly and legally liable for the VAT, making such seller internationally competitive by allowing the refund or credit of input taxes that are attributable to export sales. So where do you find this refund or credit of input taxes? That's section 112. Section 112, refunds of tax credits of input tax, zero-rated or effectively zero-rated sales. Now, effective zero rating, on the contrary, is intended to benefit the purchaser who, not being directly and legally liable for the payment of the VAT, will ultimately bear the burden of the tax shifted by the suppliers. In both instances of zero rating, there is total relief for the purchaser from the burden of the tax. But in an exemption, there is only partial relief because the purchaser is not allowed any tax refund of or credit for input taxes paid. The object of exemption from the VAT may either be the transaction itself or any of the parties. So you have this exempt transaction and you have this exempt party. So you also must be able to distinguish these two. Exempt transaction involves goods or services which, by their nature, are specifically listed in and expressly exempted from the VAT under the tax code, without regard to the tax status, VAT exempt or not, of the party to the transaction. Indeed, such transaction is not subject to VAT, but the seller is not allowed any tax refund of or credit for any input taxes paid. While, on the other hand, exempt party is a person or entity granted VAT exemption either by the tax code, special law, or international agreement, by virtue of which its taxable transactions become exempt from the VAT. Such party is also not subject to the VAT, but may be allowed a tax refund of or credit for input taxes paid, depending on its registration as a VAT or non-VAT taxpayer. Okay, an example is what? A bank. Banks are non-VAT. Okay, they are subjected to gross receipts tax, other percentage tax. Yeah, there's no escaping taxation. If you are not covered or if you're not registered as VAT, probably, most likely, 100%, you're covered under percentage tax for businesses. So, banks are, or the services of banks in section 109, where do you find that? I think it's letter victory here. Services of bank, that's exempt, one of the exempt transactions, okay? Services of bank. But the bank, whenever they buy, supplies for its operations, gasoline, etc., 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 then they would still pay for the VAT. And they will just treat that as cost of their purchases. They cannot offset that with their output VAT, obviously, because there is no output VAT for banks because they are or their services are exempt. So that's the import here, that an exempt transaction, okay, cannot, because the purchaser is not allowed any tax refund of or any credit for input taxes, because in section 112, only automatic or zero-rated transactions are allowed to avail of the provisions of section 112, not the exempt transactions. Okay, just remember this distinction. Now, and there is also this, I think this is the cinemas. Yeah. The cinemas are not imposed of the VAT. They are not covered under the VAT system because it is covered by amusement tax. Okay, so you may check your tickets. There is no VAT there. That's SM Prime Holdings. There's this interesting case, Pagcor. Pagcor is exempt from VAT because of its charter. The Supreme Court said, the rationale for the exemption from indirect taxes provided for in PD1869 and the extension of such exemption to entities or individuals dealing with Pagcor in casino operations are best elucidated from the 1987 case of Commissioner of Internal Revenue versus Gotamco, where the absolute tax exemption of the World Health Organization upon an international agreement was upheld. We held in said case that the exemption of contractee who, WHO, should be implemented to mean that the entity or person exempt is the contractor itself who constructed the building owned by the contractee WHO. And such does not violate the rule that tax exemptions are personal because the manifest intention of the agreement is to exempt the contractor so that no contractor's tax may be shifted to the contractee who. Thus, the proviso of 1869 for Pagcor, extending the exemption to entities or individuals dealing with Pagcor in casino operations, remember this, casino operations, is clearly to prescribe any indirect tax like VAT that may be shifted to Pagcor. So those who are dealing with Pagcor in casino operations, because Pagcor exempted, then the contractee, whoever is dealing with Pagcor, is also not subjected to VAT because of Pagcor's VAT exempt status. Pagcor is another, this is not the transaction of Pagcor, but Pagcor itself. Okay, that's tax exemption or VAT exemption for you. The important thing is you have to know the distinction here. And just remember, okay, automatic zero or effective zero-rated sales, services, or goods, you can avail of tax refund or credit of input taxes under what? Section 112. And remember this, SM Prime and the Pagcor. Okay? And we'll discuss Section 111 and maybe Section 112 next.